Next tonight, a teenager from Whitby who spent many months suffering from depression without discussing her problem or being diagnosed is calling on schools to start talking about mental health.
Yeah, she's enlisted the help of Fixers, the campaign that gives young people a voice to help school children nip problems in the bud.
It was just affecting me every day. It was affecting every part of my life, and it was always there. But even when I was having a better day, it was still there somewhere in the back of my mind, and I could feel it. And life just becomes a drag. I thought that the way I felt was just my personality. I was never told that it's not normal to worry about things as much as you do. I feel like if I'd have been given some coping strategies and mental health education, it wouldn't have got bigger and bigger and turned into a massive problem like it did. I'm Elise Towell, I'm 17 and I'm from Whitby. I'm working with Fixers to help young people understand how important it is to take care of their mental health. Things started for me when I was probably about 11, I think, looking back. It was just little stresses and worries. It was sort of a snowball effect. It just developed and developed, and all these little things piled up. And by the time I was 14, 15, that was when I became depressed. Basically, I just want people to know that taking care of mental health is equally as important as taking care of physical health. I don't think young people are taught about their mental health as much as they should be.
Within North Yorkshire, there's about 13,000 children with some form of mental health problem. It's important for young people to look after their mental health because it can affect every part of their life. Young people can be taught to look out for what signs and symptoms there might be that things are going wrong so that they can then go and ask for help.
At its worst, it was about being devoid of just feeling altogether. So there was no happiness, there was no sadness, there was no joy, there was nothing. It was just darkness.
Today I'm talking to Ben Milson, who has struggled with his mental health since he was 12.
I was getting really angry all the time, and I'm not really an angry person. And after I punched a couple of walls through, then that's when I realised that something was wrong. I was diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder, so OCD, and major depressive disorder.
Do you feel like when you were younger you had enough mental health education?
I don't think I was educated about mental health at all. I think there's such an emphasis on sort of physical health. If your inner psyche is not sort of in tune, then everything else is out of whack.
Do you regret not opening up to people?
Yeah, I do. I kept it to myself for about a year and a half, 2 years. If I didn't do that, if I told someone straight away, it wouldn't have got to the point where it got to, and it would have been solved much earlier.
It feels like an absolute dream come true to be able to speak out about mental health because it's something I just care about so passionately. I feel like it was my purpose to come out the other side and help other people.
Well, to see more about the story and Fixers, or to find help on this issue, you can visit fixers.org.uk.